So what does this latest development mean for the fight against ISIS and the fight here in Washington about how to take the terror group on? Illinois Senator Mark Kirk joins us now here on set. Senator, thanks for joining us. A lot's happened in this past week. Al-Qaeda and ISIS have announced a merger of some sort. We have this latest beheading video, another mention from al-Baghdadi about the United States. We're now a couple of months into President Obama's campaign against ISIS, if you want to call it that. Is it working?
No. Leland, I would say for every scalp that ISIS takes, the president should send another squadron to bomb ISIS.
Okay, I want to read a quote here from Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi. This is the leader of ISIS who put out this just in the past couple of days, one of his latest videos. America and its allies are terrified, weak, and powerless. And due to their fear and weakness, they are unable to send ground forces to fight the Mujahideen. And between this fear, weakness, and powerlessness, we see them stumbling in failure. That is the leader of ISIS, I want to say somewhere between mocking and daring the United States. What does that say about America's position in the world in this fight?
You know, right now, the president is only authorizing 5 to 7 sorties a day. If we look at this campaign compared to Kosovo, that was 2,000 sorties a day. We need a much higher op-tempo combat operations against ISIS.
You've had a lot of experience as a Navy intelligence officer in this. Is what we're doing against ISIS a comprehensive strategy, or is this sort of, we need to do something so we're going to say that we're doing something without doing enough?
This is almost just an air show over Kurdistan. I would say at 5 to 7 sorties a day, you're not really affecting the battle space enough.
And by 5 to 7 sorties, you mean 5 to 7 flights a day?
Flights with weapons on the hardpoints and being dropped.
It's not exactly the shock and awe we've seen
exactly
in the past from the U.S. military.